So, have you given any more thought to what we were talking about?
I like things the way they are.
Look, we're basically at each other's place every night as it is. If we moved in together, there'd really be no difference, honey.
Tom, come on.
I know that you have some intimacy issues, okay? I mean, who wouldn't give them what you've been through? I just want to be there for you.
That's not what this is about.
Are you sure? Because I gotta tell you, sometimes I feel like, I don't know, you're just pushing me away and I don't know why.
Honey, I have to go. I have to run. I have a meeting with the CEO in Chicago. I can't be late right now.
Look, this is exactly what I'm talking about. Okay, this, right here.
Tom, this is my career. This is what I do. This is what I do best.
We've been together for a year. And you know what? I feel like we hardly even get to see each other anymore.
I have to go, okay? I have to run. We'll talk about this later, okay? I'll be back as soon as I can. Bye.
Love you.
Wowed them at the meeting. In fact, Ron told me he felt the work you did on the Pegasus campaign was exemplary. For the first time, we're looking at a 75% market share. And with the upcoming launch of our Jupiter tablet PC, Mitchell wants someone he can trust in charge. You. VP of Worldwide Marketing for Celadon Technologies.
I don't know what to say. That's amazing.
Say yes. The company will cover all the relocation costs.
Relocation?
That's right, Boston. Ron Mitchell will be handling the launch. Naturally, there will be a substantial increase in salary. You've worked hard for this, Sonia.
Is there any way I can have some time to think about it, sir?
Of course. Got till tomorrow. This is something we need to move fast on.
Understood. I don't know how he's gonna take it.
It's not like you're moving to California.
It's 4 hours away. With traffic, 5 tops.
You're finally hitting your stride. This is an amazing opportunity. You should be happy.
But moving now. He's talking about moving in.
And what did you say?
I just said, can I have time to think about it? Tom is the first man that I've ever been able to open up to.
Are you still having nightmares about that night?
Occasionally. No, but they've virtually gone away since I've been with Tom.
Do you really think that he's the only reason they've stopped?
Possibly.
I've been your psychologist for 3 years, and I've seen you emerge out of a horrific situation and reclaim your life. Don't sell yourself short. You're stronger than you give yourself credit for. You've worked long and hard for this promotion. And if Tom loves you, he'll understand.
What if he doesn't?
Then he doesn't understand the trauma that you've been through and the changes that you need to make for yourself and no one else.
You make it sound so easy.
I'm not gonna tell you what to do with your life. But, like always, I will tell you that you need to focus on the positive. Because this is an amazing opportunity.
I know.
And if your relationship with Tom isn't meant to be, then it isn't meant to be.
Do you think it'd be possible for me to call him from here?
Yeah, absolutely.
What's up?
Everything okay?
Yeah, everything's fine. I was just wondering if you were working late tonight.
No, not too late.
I was just hoping we could talk.
About what?
Well, I don't want to discuss it on the phone.
Listen, where are you?
I'm at my therapist's office.
Connie's? I'll be there in 10 minutes. I'll see you out front.
You're doing the right thing.
Yeah. Okay. Well, I better go. He's gonna be here any second, so thank you.
Okay, well, if you need me later, you just call.
I wanted to talk to you about my promotion.
You're actually considering taking this?
it's a really big promotion. You know, Connie's fine with it.
What does your therapist have to do with this?
She's really been there for me, Tom.
Listen to me, Sonia. Okay, you are a smart, talented woman. There's gonna be other opportunities, honey. You don't have to do this.
You aren't seriously telling me to turn this offer down, are you? Don't make me choose between you and my job.
Sounds like you already have.
I can't believe you're acting like this.
My girlfriend tells me she's gonna move 200 miles away from me. What did you expect?
I expected you to be happy for me.
Oh, well, I'm sorry. I guess I'm just not as willing to throw away our relationship as easily as you are.
I can't believe this is your reaction.
Look, I gotta start my shift now. I can't do this.
What? Tom? Don't you think we should talk about this?
What good would talking do? All right? You're obsessed with your career. You always have been. I've tried to bring this up in the past. It's no good. You've already made up your mind. What's there to discuss, Sonia?
Wow. Have you been following me?
Sonia? Sonia, you here? Sonia!
This is a chance at a fresh start. A new job, a new city. I know, it's just that I thought he was a nice guy.
Well, maybe he was. But this is about you now. You're gonna meet new people and make new friends and eventually find someone to share it all with. I know you're gonna struggle with your emotions. It's perfectly normal. I'm not asking you to let go of your past. It'll always be there, but I want you to embrace your future, and I will always be there to support you day or night.
Thank you, Connie.
I'm really proud of you. You're gonna be okay.
I am.
It's interesting, isn't it? It's beautiful.
Interesting.
This artist, I really feel like he was able to bring like a real romance to his work, you know? He painted this for the love of his life.
Oh, his wife?
No, his mistress.
Typical.
I know. I'm Sebastian Crago in the gallery.
Oh, nice to meet you. I'm Sonia.
Hi.
You're to town.
Is there anything that you're interested in?
Well, I just moved to town and new place that needs a little decorating, so I thought I'd stop in your gallery and have a look.
Well, I'm here to help. You know, I have... Can I show you something?
Yeah.
This new artist we just started representing.
Sure.
This way.
Okay.
You know, I saw this guy's work, and I thought it was amazing. I thought we had to have it in the gallery for sure.
It is. It's really beautiful. I love it. Now, the ugly question, how much?
Well, it's his first sale, so $1,400.
I like it. Let's do it.
All right. Okay. Annie, could you help Mrs. Paston.
Actually, it's Ms. Paston.
Ms. Paston. She's the new owner of this piece.
Thanks.
Okay. Thanks a lot. Oh, and if you leave us with your info, we'd be happy to deliver it to you.
Okay, great.
Okay.
Sounds great.
Jupiter launch a great success, but
We're not in New York, if you don't want to sell. The answer to me directly.
Okay. Understood.
Your files are on the way as we speak. There's your office.
Perfect. Thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
Asphalt and Hyundai's. Who did you impress?
Ron Mitchell, apparently.
Anyway, I'm gonna get out of your way. I just wanted to come and say hello.
Great. Nice meeting you. Thanks. See you around.
Ladies and gentlemen, and our colleagues from across the pond, let me introduce Sonia Paston.
Thank you, sir. My deepest apologies for keeping you waiting, but I promise the wait will be well worth the inconvenience. Our company is one of the true pioneers of this industry. In a business.
Yes, I'd like to report a break-in. Yes, I live at 20950 15th Street. Please hurry. Thank you.
Did you notice anything missing?
Patrol the area.
I suggest you have your locks changed in the morning, just in case.
Okay, thanks.
Sonia, hey, it's Sebastian from the gallery.
Hi.
Is everything okay?
I came home and my door was ajar.
Did anybody get in? Is there anything taken?
Looks like no.
That's good.
Yeah, what are you doing here?
I thought I'd bring you by the painting myself, a little customer appreciation.
Thank you. Do you want to come in?
Yeah, sure.
So, would you like something to drink? Coffee or tea?
No, I'd love to, but I gotta get back to the gallery.
Oh.
Wow. Someone likes jazz.
Guilty.
I love Alex Ryak.
Yeah, me too. I saw them when I was in New Orleans. I took a trip, and they were just in town a couple months ago. I couldn't go. I had to work, so.
That's just wrong.
Yeah.
Is there anything else I can help you with while I'm here?
No. I think it's okay.
It's okay.
Yeah.
I left my card with the painting, so if you change your mind, you can just...
Okay. Thanks, I'll walk you out.
Sebastian.
Hey, hi. It's a nice surprise.
Wow, that's very chivalrous of you.
You know, hey, so how's everything going?
Great. I just want to say thank you so much for bringing that painting over the other night. That was so nice.
You're welcome.
See you around.
Okay.
Bye.
Hey, Sonia.
Yes?
I don't want to seem too forward, but are you busy on Friday night? We're having an opening at the gallery, you know, wine and cheese and a bunch of art snobs. Wait, you know what? Maybe that was too forward. I'm sorry.
How's 7?
7's good.
Okay, see you then.
Bye.
What's going on? We're just wondering who sent you the flowers.
My ex-husband never sent me flowers.
Well, that's because you got the mansion.
So? Did you make your breakfast or did you just split?
I told you, we're taking it slow.
Oh, which means you have time to check him out on the web.
I don't think that's necessary.
Nobody dates anymore without checking him out on the internet first.
You're serious?
How else are you going to know what sick message boards he's been visiting, or if he's a total psycho?
I don't know. Does the talk spend time together?
That's a tad old-fashioned.
Okay.
Hey, do you work out?
Do I work out?
Yeah.
Sometimes?
Yeah, because I go to the gym every day. I'd love a workout, buddy.
Oh, okay. That sounds fun.
Sure. Okay, so shoot me your email address, and I'll pop by and pick you up in the morning.
The morning.
Thank you.
know. I know. And I feel better. Well, he sounds like a wonderful guy.
Just promise me you'll take things slowly.
There's no rush.
I know. Don't worry.
Sonia, you there? I
thought I heard something outside.
Well, keep me updated, okay?
Will do. Talk to you later.
Okay, bye.
I was thinking that this campaign should emphasize value, possibly creating a new pricing tier for the Jupiter launch. While our core customers will continue to pay full price for the product, my research indicates that a value tier be created for the Jupiter tablet, therefore allowing new customers to get their foot in the door.
I like it. And I think there's an opportunity to expand this thinking throughout our entire product line. I want you to pitch this directly to our retail division, Sonia, tomorrow.
Yes, sir. Okay.
Sonia, something more important?
Of course not. No.
Good. Then my office will set up the meeting. Remember, we have the reps from our London office coming in next week, so I want you to pitch it to them, too. That is, if you think you can handle it.
I can handle it, sir.
Okay. All right, everybody, let's get back to work.
And Mitchell, he's the CEO, right?
Yes.
He seems to think very highly of you.
Well, as he should. Why are you jealous?
I don't know. Is he married?
Very married with children.
Let me see. I'll tell you what. I want you to relax, okay? Let's not talk about work anymore. And I want to wow you with my culinary abilities.
Deal.
Bill, can you cut the mushrooms? I'd like to see Mitchell try this, you know?
What?
The sauce. You wait. It's almost ready. I'll show you. Is it okay? Just let me show you here.
Okay.
Just so you're safe with the knife, just turn your fingers over like that just a little bit, and then you won't cut yourself, and you'll be safe.
Yeah, this is Officer Doherty with NYPD, badge number 902. Calling in a person of interest. Surname is Craig. It's Charlie Romeo Alpha India Golf. Right. First name Sebastian. No criminal record. Okay.
Thank you. I owe you one. Okay, bye. Guess what?
What?
Good news, my buddy. Just got his ticket. kids tonight to go see this amazing quartet at the ground beat.
In town?
In town, yeah. What do you think?
I have a presentation tomorrow. I...
If you like Alex Roark, you're gonna love these guys.
Sold out show. It's gonna be amazing. I'm going.
Well, I suppose I could work something out.
Really?
Okay, I gotta go. I'll pick you up tonight.
I can't wait.
Don't forget that we want to put the Hutchinson up here. And we also have to wrap that piece up for Mrs. Shanley.
Sebastian Art Gallery. Oh, it's Miss Paston's office.
Good. Hello.
Oh, I'm sorry. This is Sonia's assistant, David. She asked me to call you to tell you that she's incredibly sorry, but she's going to have to cancel for this evening.
Okay, I understand.
She said for you to go ahead and have a great evening without her. She'll call you in the morning.
Is she there? Can I speak to her for a second?
Oh, I'm sorry. She's in with Mr. Mitchell at the moment.
Okay, just tell her that I'll talk to her later.
Have a good evening.
Is everything okay?
Yeah, she canceled.
Hi, Sebastian. It's Sonia. I'm just calling to let you know that I'm very excited about tonight and that I look forward to seeing you. Bye. No, I feel like the stats are totally matching up to our projections. It's going well. I feel good about it. Hey, I'll get back to you later, okay? Great. Bye.
Hi. Yeah, you missed a really, really good show last night.
Hi. Because I was waiting for you all evening. You didn't even have the decency to call.
You canceled on me.
I canceled.
Yeah. And your assistant called me and said to tell me that you couldn't make it. Do you think I'm making it up?
I don't know. Maybe you have me confused with another woman.
Another woman.
You know, I rescheduled a really important meeting for you, which I should have never done.
I don't know what's going on. I don't know who took that picture, but that's actually my sister. My sister went with me. It's not what you think.
Really? What am I thinking, Sebastian? Never mind. I don't even want to know. You know, I'm sure I am one of many.
Huh. You know, I know that you're... Obviously, you're upset. But I didn't stand you up.
I have work to do.
Can we talk about this?
This isn't the place nor the time.
It's a misunderstanding, Sonia.
You found your way in, right? Can you find your way out?
can't believe you did that.
I know. I thought things were going well, and he was a nice guy.
Well, it's a drag. I know you liked him.
Yeah. But he lied. You know, that's the worst part.
Well, you said you were not committed, so you have to move on. Believe me, there's a lot of fish in the sea.
Yeah, but maybe I don't want another fish, you know? I'm already swamped to my eyeballs.
Well, I'm not saying relationship. I'm just saying, you know, single girls should be out having some fun. Fun? Yeah. You know what?
What?
I'm gonna get back to work.
Oh, well, I'm gonna go another half an hour. I cannot go back to the office right now.
Okay. I'll see you then.
See you there. Bye.
You're not answering my phone calls. You didn't answer my texts. I came by to see if you're okay.
I'm fine.
Then I wanted to say that I'm sorry.
You already said that.
Come on, let me make it up to you. Let me give you some heat.
Sebastian, you went.
I really don't think we should see each other anymore.
Listen, your office called me.
I trusted you. You let me down. It's over.
Come.
Good evening.
See how you do with a criminal record.
Sebastian, is that you?
Special for this presentation. I need you to get those profiles on each person that's attending, okay?
Hey, the plot thickens.
Oh, you know, some guys just get the message.
Because they don't want to.
God, he's starting to creep me out.
Why? It's not like he's stalking you. Is he stalking you?
No, I don't know. It's just that last night at the park and then yesterday, I don't know, I'm starting to feel like someone's watching me.
Do you know what I would do?
What?
Don't move.
Okay.
just take it. And then if you need protection, then at least you have it. I've got a ton of work to do, so I'll catch you later.
Okay, sure. Okay.
Well, thank you very much for coming down.
We just want to make sure everything's okay.
This is Sebastian, our owner. Sebastian, this is Officer Johnson.
Oh, hi. What can I do for you?
Department's had a number of complaints about break-ins in the area. We're just checking in with local business owners, making sure we haven't missed anything.
Okay. Can I ask you to hold on just a second? I got a couple of clients I just need to get to.
Of course. If you guys haven't had any problems, I'll just show myself out.
Okay, great. Right. Thanks for coming by. Nice to meet you.
Please be advised that the query Craig Sebastian turned up two results. Office, please. Hi, Ron. It's Sonia. I am literally walking through the door right now, okay? I feel good about the presentation. It'll go great. Just give me a second. I'll be right up. Awesome. Thank you. Sebastian?
Sonia.
What are you doing here?
I wanted to talk.
You've done enough.
What are you talking about?
Oh, I found your phone.
My phone?
You must have dropped it last night.
Well, I lost it, yeah.
And I know about the restraining order.
Restraining order? I don't...
Were you the one who broke into my house?
Sorry?
You just so happened to be here. How convenient. While the police were here?
I came by to see if you were okay.
You know what? Just stay with me.
What is going on? You're not making any sense.
If I find you on my property, I will have you arrested.
Well, I don't know who you've been speaking to or what you've been told, but... Sonia!
Goodbye. Hello?
Hey, it's me. Tom.
How you been?
Fine.
Is this a bad time?
No. Why?
I know you sound a little stressed out, that's all. Is everything okay?
Everything's fine. I'm fine.
Listen, the reason I'm calling is that I'm at the precinct right now, but I'm going to be coming down your way for a couple of days.
Thought it might be nice to catch up, grab a coffee, maybe.
Oh. I don't think that's such a good idea.
Look, no pressure, Sonia. I just thought it would be nice to see you, that's all.
Yeah.
Sounds like you could use some company, too.
Yeah, maybe.
All right, I'll tell you what.
I could be down your way for, let's say 1 o'clock tomorrow afternoon.
Okay, sure, why not?
All right.
Looking forward to it. I'll see you then.
Okay. Do you think maybe you're overreacting?
I don't know. I found his telephone lying on the ground, and it turns out that he has a restraining order against him and other charges, too.
I'm scared, Connie. I'm starting to get the nightmares again, and I'm not
sleeping. It's starting to affect my work.
That's what therapy is for, to help you through these episodes. I don't know. Maybe coming here was a mistake. And then Tom calls.
I'm really happy to hear his voice.
Tom called? Yes. What did he say?
I don't know. He just...
He's in town for a couple of days and he wants to see me.
I hope you said no.
We're gonna grab a cup of coffee.
Sonia, it's just coffee, Connie.
I'm actually looking forward to seeing him.
Well, it's natural to want to reach out to the past.
But this is about moving forward, not backward.
Are you listening to what I'm saying? Yes. Call me later, okay? Okay, bye. So, what are you doing down here?
Oh, an old buddy of mine from the force is throwing a little retirement party. He's moving into a place on the Cape.
Oh, that sounds nice.
I don't know about that. But, it gives me a chance to get out of the city. Come visit you.
Oh.
How are things outside of the workplace?
Are you asking me if I'm dating anyone?
I don't know. Are you?
I was.
But,
It's over.
Oh. So. Anything you want to talk about? Do you ever think about me or us?
Sometimes. Why do you think about me?
Sometimes.
There's actually something I've been wanting to talk to you about that's been bothering me.
Yeah, what?
Well, when I was getting my things from your house, I bumped the computer and I saw that there was a file that had pictures of me in it.
Right.
Well, it was a little...
creepy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Were you having me followed?
Truthfully, yes.
Why?
Look, you were still... naturally worried about what you had just gone through. And so I asked somebody from my department to just sort of keep an eye on you. And I'll make sure that you're okay. I know, Sonia, it was for your own protection. Okay, and I know that if I had told you, there's no way you would have gone along with it. So I'm sorry. I really should have been honest with you and told you, but...
Yeah.
But I don't know what I would have done if something had happened to you. I just wanted to make sure that you were safe. Sorry. Okay. Come on. Let me drive you home.
Okay.
office. You gonna be okay?
I think so.
Sonia!
Since you left, I feel like there's something missing in my life. Maybe we can't make this long distance thing work.
I can't.
Why?
Because, I mean, there's just so much going on here. I wouldn't even know where to start.
Okay, what about what just happened out there?
Nothing happened.
What, are you telling me you don't feel anything for me now?
It's just like Connie. I told Connie that I couldn't...
Wait a second. Connie? Your therapist?
I just told her I would grab a cup of coffee with you, and that's all.
How is this any of her business? Tell me that.
She wants what's best for me.
That makes two of us.
Tom, you should go.
No.
Your last appointment is here. David Moore?
Send him in.
Do you mind if I leave for the evening?
No, you go ahead. I can lock up.
Have a good night, Dr. Landon.
You too.
be David.
Yes, I am. Thank you for seeing me. I don't know, I guess I just needed to talk to somebody.
Come on in. Please, take a seat wherever you're comfortable. So, why don't you tell me what's bothering you?
Well, my girlfriend and I recently broke up, and it's been difficult. I haven't been eating. I sleep an hour a night, maybe, if that. And I'm a little embarrassed. I'm a cop, and I guess I feel, you know, I'm not supposed to be so upset by this kind of stuff, you know.
No one's judging you, though.
Look, the reason why I'm here is I just want to be able to move forward in my life. And, you know, I guess stop obsessing over her.
And what is it exactly that you've been obsessing about?
What she's doing, who she's with. You know, stuff like that.
So, who broke up with who?
She broke up with me.
Did she explain why?
Well, she moved.
She moved, okay.
I practically begged her to stay, but, you know, she had made up her mind. And I tell you, it, made me feel like maybe I wasn't good enough for her.
So what did you do?
Well, I found out where she moved to, and I followed her.
Sorry. You said you followed her?
Yeah. To a new place. Actually, I broke into her house. Would you believe that she didn't even have one picture of me put up in her place?
All that time we were together, yet not one picture.
So anyways, I installed one of those little hidden cameras they have, you know? And I watched. And one night, I noticed that she brought home a new guy. And I listened to her talk to one of her good friends about how she wasn't going to rush into anything. You know, she was going to take it nice and slow. But this art gallery owner had sex with my girlfriend.
You're Tom.
And I was kind of thinking that maybe I would be the guy that she needed in her life to protect her. And maybe this new guy, well, he wasn't such the great and wonderful person after all, once she got to know him. I don't know, somehow she'd just come back to me. I mean, that's what I was thinking anyway. But, you know what happened? Her therapist told her to stay away from me. I mean, why would she do that? Why would she try to get in between the two of us?
You shouldn't be here.
She had no right.
Listen to me.
You tell me. What would you do if you were me? What would you do to the woman who destroyed our relationship? What would you do?
I think you need help.
Is that your professional opinion, Doc? Oh, I know what you're thinking, but, your receptionist left for the night. If you remember, I'm afraid it's just, you and me tonight.
Hurting you won't help.
I'm not gonna hurt you, Colleen. I mean, how would that look if I
Sebastian Craig?
Yeah.
Detective Curtis, homicide.
Homicide.
You're under arrest for the murder of Connie Landon.
What?
Cuff him.
No, you got to know until you get the wrong person.
We'll see about that. Let's go.
No, there's a mistake here. Come on.
Ow! Ow! Eddie! It's a mistake! Eddie!
Anything you say, Kenny.
Call my lawyer! Eddie!
Sonia Paston?
Yes, that's me.
I'm Detective Curtis of the Homicide Division.
Right, they said you were in my office. Is there something I can help you with?
I'm sorry to be the one to have to tell you this, but Connie Landon was killed last night. She was murdered. Pulled her phone records, and we found that you were one of the last people to call her. We have a suspect in custody here in Waltham. His name is Sebastian Craig. Is it true you know this man?
Yeah.
I'm gonna have to ask you to come down to the precinct and make a statement.
May I please have a moment?
Absolutely. I'll wait for you outside.
Thank you.
This letter. His turnpike toll unit was tagged heading out of state the night she died. He used his credit card at a coffee shop up the street 30 minutes prior to her death. And we found strands of hair in the trunk of his car. Matches the victim's DNA. You sure you want to see him?
Yeah.
Okay. You got 5 minutes.
Thanks, Detective. My fault. I told him about her.
You can't think that way.
You know, he literally said, I'm gonna have to do something about her.
There's no way you could have known.
What was I thinking?
We're gonna get through this, I promise.
You know, that funeral is early next week. I'm gonna have to go back.
Well, if you want some company, I'll drive out there with you.
Thank you. But, I think it's gonna be a one-way trip.
What?
I can't stay here.
Are you kidding? You have a great job. You can't give up on that now.
What am I supposed to do? Just forget that everything happened?
I don't know. Take a weekend. Get out of town.
Where would we go?
We could go to my summer place.
So take the weekend, and if you want to move home after that, I promise I won't stop you. Please.
Okay.
Great.
So get a good night's sleep, and we'll head out first thing in the morning.
figures you want for the total and surveillance?
Great.
I just got off the phone with a credit card company. Apparently, Sebastian used his credit card here in Welford 2 minutes after the time of death.
So, if the credit card was cloned, which transaction is his?
I asked for a photo. But he wasn't in New York.
He's being set up. Okay. This is Detective Curtis. I need a New York plate check. Delta Mike Hotel, 81, Kilo 5. So we're missing something here, huh? I'm gonna dig deeper into the shrink and her patient client list. Yeah. Thank you. Stolen.
Surprise, friends.
I will bet you a week's salary that there is a connection between Sonia and this murder, so you dig around in there a little bit deeper, all right?
Done.
Looks like Sebastian's a free man.
Is everything okay?
Get out of the car. Or I will shoot your friend dead right now. It's your call.
Let's just get out of the car.
Get out. Move it.
Sonia!
are you taking us?
I've got a place in mind.
He's supposed to be locked away in jail.
It was perfect, you know?
I just needed to remove the distraction that was getting between us.
What are you talking about?
I killed Connie. And I framed Sebastian for it. It was beautiful, Sonia. It was the perfect crime. Sonia, are you okay?
No.
Listen, come on, let's go.
came to her rescue. Bravo.
Who are you?
Hey, no, put it down!
Don't. You really should be in jail right now. I guarantee you that would be the safest place for you tonight.
You set me up.
Yeah, I did. It was a big mistake coming between me and her.
Tom, Sebastian has nothing to do with this.
I disagree with that. See, the plan was very simple. I kill her therapist. I pin it on you. And then we go back to the way things were. I don't think that's gonna happen to you.
Tom, it doesn't have to be this way.
Yes, it does. I kill both of you. And I make it look like a murder-suicide. Nice and tidy.
I can hear you moving. I know you're there. I will find you. Don't make this harder than it needs to be.
Just want to talk, honey. I know you're in here. Sonia.
He's running from me, aren't you?
Tom. Don't hurt me.
Didn't have to be like this, you know. If you'd just listen to me. Connie, Sebastian, they'd still be alive. We'd be back in New York. Like we used to be.
He can't hurt us. You're bleeding.
I'll tell you, I'll be all right.
Oh,
isn't over.
Get him out of here.
Don't worry about him. He's going to prison for a very long time. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm okay. Thank you.
Turns out he's a very lucky guy.
Okay, let's go. Okay, let's go. Okay, let's go.